Welcome to the presentation. I myself, Akash Rajpurohit, Raj Kotadia, and Sanchit Sagar Singh are going to give you a presentation on a mini project of IOE, which will be the MQTT protocol. We will give you a technical information about the MQTT protocol as well as demonstrate the simulation of MQTT protocol using Contiki OS and Kuja software. So let's get started. Now let's first start with introducing MQTT protocol. MQTT stands for Message Queuing Telemetry Protocol. It is a simple messaging protocol designed for constrained devices with low bandwidth. The protocol uses a publish-subscribe communication pattern, which makes it easy to send commands to control outputs, read and publish data from sensor nodes, and much more. The MQTT protocol is a good choice for wireless networks that experience varying levels of latency due to the occasional bandwidth constraints or unreliable connections. This protocol is used for machine-to-machine, that is M2M communication, and plays an important role in Internet of Things. Let's take a quick overview of what the MQTT protocol has. The protocol surrounds two subjects, that is a client and a broker. An MQTT broker is a server, while the clients are the connected devices. When a device or a client wants to send a data to a server or a broker, it is called publish. When the operation is reversed, it is called subscribe. Now let's go through some basic concepts of MQTT protocol. First thing is the architecture that it follows, which is the PubSub architecture or the publisher-subscriber model. In the publish and subscribe system, a device can publish a message to a topic, or it can be subscribed to a particular topic and receive messages. If you want to relate it to a real-world example, you subscribe to a particular YouTube channel, and whenever a video is posted on that channel, all the subscribers listening to that publisher gets the message. The same thing is happened using the MQTT protocol, which follows the same PubSub architecture. Second is MQTT messages. These messages are the information that you want to exchange between your devices, whether it's a command or a data. MQTT topics. Topics are the way you register interest for incoming messages, or how you specify where you want to publish the message. And finally, the MQTT broker. The broker is primarily responsible for receiving all the messages, filtering those messages, decide who is interested in them, and then publishing those messages to the subscribed clients. Now let's see how MQTT works. An MQTT session is divided into four stages: connection, authentication, communication, and termination. Let's go one by one in each of the stages. So the first stage, which is connection. The client starts to create a TCP/IP connection to the broker by using either a standard port or a custom port defined by the broker's operation. Authentication phase. During the SSL TLS handshake, the client validates the server certificate and authenticates the server. The client may also provide a client certificate to the broker during this handshake. The broker can use this to authenticate the client. Next is the communication phase. During the communication phase, a client can perform publish, subscribe, unsubscribe, and ping operations. The public operation sends a binary block of data, that is the content, to a topic that is defined by the publisher. Topic subscriptions are made using the subscribe subback packet pair, and unsubscribing similar performed using the unsubscribe unsubback packet pair. Ping operation is basically to test if the connection is successful or not. The final stage is termination. When a publisher or subscriber wants to terminate an MQTT session, it sends a disconnect message to the broker and then it closes the connection. This is what we call is a graceful shutdown, because it gives the client the ability to easily reconnect by providing its client identity and resuming where it left off. So now, as we have seen all the terminologies, now let's get with the implementation part of it on the Contiki OS and Kuja software. So now let's start with the demonstration of our project. So we have used Contiki version 3.0, which is the latest release in the year 2015,
and we are using VirtualBox for our VM setup. Now we will start the VM and we have already loaded the Quantiki OS to it. The OS creates a sample user for us called Instant Quantiki, and the password is user, so we'll just use that user to log into the system. Now, first thing we have to start the Quantiki, first we have to start the Pooja software. So we'll head over to the files in the Quantiki tools and in the Pooja folder. Now we will use a program called Ant, which is a Java based program which is used to run the Pooja simulation. So we'll start the program typing Ant run. It will boot up our Pooja simulation. Now as you can see here, the Pooja has started successfully. Now we'll create a new simulation. Let's call it MQTT demo, which is our project. Okay, so this is the main interface that the Pooja software has. We will have a network tab here, where we'll be showing the network structure, how it is placed. We'll create something called as a modes. Modes are basically simple nodes that we have on our network. So we'll create a first mode, which will be of type sky mode. And this would be a server, main server that would be handling those things. And it would be a border router. So we'll write the description as border router. And we'll choose the Quantiki process, which is found in the files, in the examples, under the IPv6 folder and the RPL border router. So we'll use this mode type, and we'll compile this to check if it's right. Once we have done that, we'll create the mode. We'll create a single mode only for now. So now we have successfully created our first mode, which is a border router. Now we'll add enable certain attributes for it, so we can see during a simulation, like mode IDs, addresses on the IPv6, IP addresses. We'll add a grid so we can view more detail, and a mode type which defines what is the current mode type. As we have seen in the previous PPTs, we have a PubSub architecture in this thing. So this is our main server that will be handling those things, and then we will create two another modes, which would be one for publisher and one for the subscriber. So now let's first create another mode of the same type, sky mode, and this time this would be a publisher mode. Now for this we will use the package which we have already downloaded here. It's MQTT SN Quantiki, and in this we will find a file called main.core, which has the publisher as well as a subscriber code written in it. So we'll compile and create one publisher first. As you can see that we have added another mode into this network, that is publisher, which is currently not in the range of the our main server, so we'll try to put it in the same range. Now as you can see, the publisher and the main server are in the radius which brings them in the same network. So with the help of this, we will be able to connect both of them in the network. Now let's add another mode, which will be our final mode, that would be a subscriber. So we'll create a subscriber. It will contain the same main core file, and we'll add this to the network interface as well. Now one thing about this interfacing is that we don't need to add a subscriber directly into the radius of the server. The subscriber can be in the radius of the publisher as well. Even though it is not in direct connection with the server, it would be still be able to have a connection with the entire system. So that is a good part about MQTT. Now, as you can see, we have added the subscriber, which is in the radius of the publisher, not the server. So this is a basic setup that we have created. Now, let's follow up the next steps, which is we will start another terminal. We will go into the examples folder for the RPL border router, and we will actually compile all the C binaries that we have for the type of connect router Pooja. So this is the main command that we will want to use to compile all the C files that we have here. But before that, first we will have to start up the server. So we will do that just now. We will do a serial socket, and the default port is 60001. It will start on that port. So it has started now. Next thing, we will start with the start with the compilation. So now as we can see that it has started on the localhost point. So now it has started successfully. So let's move to the next step, which is allow, we will open another terminal. And now we are going to use something called as a message broker, which will be helpful for passing all the messages in the network. And we will use a famous one called Mosquito RSMB. What it will do is it will start the Mosquito with the configuration file that we had fed, which was config.mqtt, and it will start listening on the ports 1883 and 1884. These are the MQTT protocols that will get started and start listening to that thing. Now the server is listening on 60001. We'll start the simulation now to see what happens. Now as you can see, it made a connection with the publisher first and then to the subscriber. And the, in the logs, we can see that the connection was successful. It registered properly, and now the entire simulation shows us that the first the server got connected with the publisher. Now the publisher is connected with the subscriber. So any messages that goes to a publisher, the subscriber listening to that publisher will get those messages with the MQTT protocol. So this is the basic simulation that we have done with Kuja software. And in the logs, you can see that there are messages being sent through and forth from the system. And this shows a demonstration of the MQTT protocol using the publisher and subscriber architecture. Thank you.